Hello everyone, I welcome you all to my channel Wins Academy for Competitive Exams. In this video, we are going to see Divergence Theorem, Stokes Theorem, Capacitance, Electric Field Intensity and the problems that are asked in competitive exams. The learning objectives are Divergence Theorem, Stokes Theorem, Capacitance, Energy Stored in a Capacitor, Electric Field Intensity and the problems. So, before going to see the theorem, we should know three types of integrals. The first one is integral dl. This means it is line integral. Line integral means it is one dimensional. See, consider a line. So, it has only length. So, it is one dimensional. Then the second one is double integral ds. It is called as surface integral. So, consider a surface. This surface has a surface area? Yes. So, it has two dimensions. One is length and another one is breadth. So, it is two dimensional. Then the third one is triple integral dv. It is called as volume integral. So, consider this volume. It has three dimensions. Length, breadth and width. Divergence theorem. Divergence theorem states that the total outward flux of a vector field A through the closed surface S is same as the volume integral of the divergence of A. So, divergence theorem relates surface integral and volume integral. Already we have seen double integral means surface integral, triple integral means volume integral. So, double integral, that is surface integral of a vector, is equal to volume integral of divergence of that vector. This is called as divergence theorem. The next one is Stokes theorem. The surface integral of the curl of a vector over any closed surface is equal to the line integral of the vector around a closed path bounding the surface. Stokes theorem relates line integral and surface integral. So, line integral of a vector is equivalent to surface integral of curl of that vector. This is called as Stokes theorem. Next one is capacitance. A capacitor is capable of storing electrical charge and energy. So, to store the electrical charge, we will be using a capacitor. The higher the value of capacitance, then more charge the capacitor can store. So, here we are going to see two types of capacitors. One is parallel plate capacitor and an isolated sphere capacitor. So, parallel plate capacitor, consider two parallel plates separated by a distance D and a supply voltage V is given. So, for parallel plate capacitor, capacitance is equal to Q by V. Q is the charge, V is the potential. So, that is equal to epsilon A divided by D, where A is the area and epsilon is equal to epsilon naught into epsilon R. So, we know epsilon naught constant value is equal to 8.854 into 10 power minus 12. Then the second one, the capacitance of an isolated sphere is given by C equal to 4 pi epsilon naught into R. The next one is energy stored in a capacitor. The energy stored in a capacitor is given by E is equal to 1 by 2 CV square, where C is the capacitance, V is the potential. Normally, we will be ranging the capacitor values as milli or micro or nano or pico. Milli means 10 power minus 3. Micro means 10 power minus 6, nano means 10 power minus 9 and pico means 10 power minus 12. So, next we are going to see electric field intensity. Already we have seen the definition for electric field intensity. Here for capacitance we are using another one definition. E is equal to V by D, where V is the potential between the two parallel plates and D is the distance between the two parallel plates. So, E is equal to V by D. So, next we are going to see some problems that are asked in competitive exams. So, first question. This is asked in GATE. Consider a closed surface S surrounding a volume V. If R vector is the position vector of a point inside S, With n cap, the unit normal on S, the value of the integral, double integral, 5 r vector dot n cap ds is. So, here we have to find out the answer. So, first of all, understand the question clearly. Here they have asked closed surface S as well as volume V. So, it relates surface integral and volume integral. Divergence theorem relates surface integral and the volume integral. Surface integral of a vector is equal to volume integral of divergence of that vector. Then, here it is given r vector as the position vector. Position vector of any point is defined as the directed distance from the origin. So, here we are considering the point is x, y, z. So, r vector is equal to x ax vector plus y ay vector plus z az vector. Then, triple integral of dv vector is equal to the total volume. So, total volume here is capital V. Then, we have to find the divergence of r vector, del dot r vector. So, if you want to recall the divergence formula, you can refer the description box. Del dot r vector is equal to 3. So, substitute these answers, you will be getting 5 into 3V. So, that is equal to 15V. So, the answer is option D. Next problem. This problem is asked in TRB. If del dot f vector equal to 3, then double integral of f vector dot n cap ds, where s is the surface of a unit sphere is. So, here we have to calculate what is double integral of f vector dot n cap ds. So, here this is surface integral and this is divergence. So, by using the divergence theorem, we can relate this. Surface integral of a vector is equivalent to volume integral of divergence of that vector. Then, in the question given, del dot f vector is equal to 3. So, we can substitute that value in the triple integral 3 into dv vector. So, here the volume for a unit sphere is 4 by 3 pi r cube. Since it is unit sphere, r is equal to 1. So, by substituting these values, we will be getting the answer as 4 pi. So, option C is the right answer. So, next question. This is also asked in TRB. What is the capacitance of a capacitor having a stored energy of 10 microjoules with an applied voltage of 5 volt? So, energy and voltage is given. We have to find out the capacitance value. Already we have seen energy formula. E is equal to half CV square. So, here V we know as well as E also we know. We have to find C. So, C is equal to 2E divided by V square. So, that is equal to 0.8 microfarad. So, option B is the right answer. So, next problem. In this problem, if a vector field V vector is related to another vector field A vector through V vector equal to del cross A vector, which of the following is true? So, here it is given as curl. Del cross A vector is curl. So, V vector is equal to curl of A vector. So, option A, integral, this is line integral. Integral V vector dot dl vector is equal to double integral A vector dot ds vector. Then, option B, line integral A vector dot dl vector is equal to double integral of del cross A vector dot ds vector. Then, option C, line integral of del cross V vector dot dl vector is equal to double integral of del cross A vector dot ds vector. Then option D, line integral of del cross A vector dot dl vector is equal to double integral of V vector dot ds vector. So, already we have seen single integral means it is line integral and double integral means it is surface integral. So, Stokes theorem relates the line integral and surface integral. So, line integral of a vector is equal to surface integral of curl of a vector. So, here in option B, we are having line integral of a vector, A vector dot dl vector is equal to surface integral of curl of A vector dot ds vector. So, this is the right answer. Option B is the right answer. So, next problem. A parallel plate capacitor filled with two dielectrics is shown in the figure below If the electric field in the region A is 4 kilovolt per centimeter, we have to find what is the electric field in region B. So this is the figure, this is region A and this is region B, and in between the two parallel plates the distance is 2 centimeter. So here we have to use the formula E is equal to V by D, where V is the potential and D is the distance between the two parallel plates. Always remember, the potential and the distance will be constant for the two dielectrics. That is, we are applying a potential between the two parallel plates like this. So its voltage V is applied for A as well as for B. So V remains constant. Similarly, D is the distance between the two parallel plates. So for dielectric B, the distance D is equal to 2 cm. Similarly, for dielectric A, the distance D is equal to 2 cm. Therefore, E remains same throughout the region. Therefore, capital E for B region is equal to 4 kilovolt per meter. That is, the answer is 4. Option C. So, next problem. There are two conducting plates of sizes 1 meter cross 1 meter and 2 meter cross 2 meter. Ratio of the capacitance of the second one with respect to that of first one, we have to calculate it. So here, two conducting plates, one conducting plate size is 1 meter cross 1 meter and the other conducting plate size is 2 meter cross 2 meter. Therefore, we have to use the formula C is equal to epsilon A divided by D. So for the first parallel plate, C1 is equal to epsilon R1 A1 divided by D. And for the second parallel plate, C2 is equal to epsilon R2 A2 divided by D. So here we have to know what is A1 and A2. A1 is equal to 1 because the size is 1 meter cross 1 meter. So length into breadth, that is our area. So A1 is equal to 1 and A2 is equal to 4. 2 into 2, 4. So by substituting these values, you will be getting C2 by C1 is equal to 4. So answer is option A. So we have come to the end of the session. Now we are going to summarize it. So first, divergence theorem. Surface integral of a vector is equal to volume integral of divergence of a vector. So divergence theorem relates surface integral and volume integral. Stokes theorem. Line integral of a vector is equivalent to surface integral of curl of a vector. So Stokes theorem relates line integral and surface integral. Then capacitance. For parallel plate, C equal to epsilon A divided by D. Isolated sphere, C equal to 4 pi epsilon naught R. Then energy stored in a capacitor, E is equal to 1 by 2 CV square. Then at last, electric field intensity, E is equal to V by D. I hope you all understood the problems. If you like this video, kindly subscribe and press the bell button so that you can receive the notification about my forthcoming videos. Let us understand and grow. Thank you.